such a beautiful day out here. How many of you would like to be out here fishing or swimming or maybe canoeing? When you're out here, have you ever taken a moment to actually look at what's in the water? Maybe you'll see a school of fish or a manatee or maybe a dolphin. But let's...
When you hear the word plankton, what do you think of? Is it this guy? The guy who steals Krabby Patties from SpongeBob? I bet your first thought didn't lead you to come up with names like Cosmodiscus, Protosigma, Rhizoselenia, and Bassillaria. These are just a few examples of plankton found in real life. But today we're going to teach you how to properly count and identify these different species. Before you can identify, you first need to collect a sample. Plankton can be found in both saltwater and freshwater environments and are most likely found in the depths of the water column. By pulling out plankton net through the water, you are able to trap them and have collected a usable sample. To start the identification process, you need to first set up a slide. Begin by slowly shaking the water sample back and forth until the water is stirred up. This makes sure that the plankton is equally distributed in the water. Next, you want to pipe out 1 gram of the sample onto a slide and place a cover slip on top. Now you are ready to begin searching for the plankton. Once you have your slide and microscope set up, you can begin looking at the different plankton species. Identifying can be the hardest part because to the untrained eye, they all look the same. However, by picking out different characteristics like size, shape, color, or the way they move, all helps to narrow down the different species. For example, Bassillaria are pinnate plankton, which are usually long and thin, whereas Cosmodiscus is eccentric plankton, which are usually characterized by their bodies being completely symmetrical. Another way to tell the difference between the plankton is by things that stand out. For example, Rhizoselenia can have extended points coming off their body, whereas Protosigma will not. To keep consistency in your methods, it's important to search on low and identify on high. This makes sure that you aren't missing any plankton and are properly identifying them. In order to get a correct plankton count, while going through the slide, write down the different species you have identified. Each time you see another plankton of the same species, make a tally mark next to the name on your sheet. At the end, you should have an accurate count of phytoplankton on that slide.
So what you just saw in this video was how to properly set up a slide and a basic outline of how to count and identify phytoplankton by their different characteristics. Hopefully this video will be a valuable resource for your class if you decide to do any other plankton activities.